Craziest story of all day. I'm telling you what. Did you know desert tortoises hibernate for the winter?
Who knew? Apparently, our resident tortoise expert did, and he's more to tell us here to tell us more. Doug Ryan here from KSL News Radio. Of course, the stalwart of this time of year, of this cycle of politics and everything. But Doug, I didn't know you had such a hidden talent here.
Well, actually,
the tortoise whisperer.
He's the tortoise whisperer. This is my son Ian.
Oh, hey,
his wife Tyra, my daughter-in-law. And Ian, you've loved turtles ever since you were a little boy.
Yeah, I have, but I never envisioned having a desert tortoise.
Yeah.
But
okay, so let's talk yes. about this. First off, these are endangered.
Right.
So even to adopt it, you had to go through a bunch of bureaucratic paperwork.
Oh, it's amazing. Ian came home one day, and this is before he and Tyra were married, and said, "I'd like to adopt a desert tortoise." And what does that take?
It takes a lot. You have to have people come over, and they look at your yard, and they check you, and they make sure if there's any dogs. It's quite an extensive process.
Yeah, he said, you know, we're just going to put him in a little bit of the yard. And so all of a sudden, he's out there building all these barricades, running boards across, which makes it very difficult to mow.
Right, of course.
And but Winston had just an actual haven, and pretty soon, just like Harry Potter, he's going to go in the cupboard under the stairs.
Mm-hmm. He hibernates under the stairs.
For how
hibernates,
long?
Wow.
About April, and then you start, when the temperature is below 50, you want to bring him inside. So in the spring, you take him outside and they'll roam around, and if it gets cold, they're kind of like a lawn ornament that moves except for in the spring. Like, that's when you have to bring him in and out.
See, Tyra married into this. She had no idea.
Tyra, what'd you think of all this?
Well, Ian and I were dating when he decided to apply for Winston, and we were just hanging out one night, and he said, "I want to get a turtle." And I'm thinking, oh, maybe I'll be a cute girlfriend and go pick him one up at PetSmart. And then the next day he comes home and he's like, "No, I'm going to go big or go home on this, so I'm going to apply and adopt a desert tortoise." And I was just like, what? So wow. Here we are, but we really like him. He's fun.
Okay, so in case you didn't hear it on KSL News Radio today, they actually had a happy hibernation show, a wish for Winston. And you had political stalwarts calling in, like Peter Caroon. Listen to this.
Hi there, Winston. Peter Caroon here from the Utah Democratic Party. From one endangered species to another, I just want you to wish you a happy hibernation. But before you take your snooze, don't forget to mail in your ballot. As you know, 21 out of our 29 counties this year are voting by mail. And even though you'll be asleep on election day, it's important to make your voice count. When you wake up, it'll be a new world, Winston. One with our first woman president. And you'll take great pride in knowing you helped make that happen.
Wow.
Happy hibernating.
So there you go. Who knew? Who knew you had a desert tortoise? And it's not something you can just say, hey, I want to adopt. But they have to be injured in some sort, and that's why they take them out of the wild. Is that correct?
What people don't realize is that you should not pick up, you should not adopt yourself unofficially a desert tortoise, and they don't want to release them back in because of human contact, disease, things like that. So it's a big deal.
Yeah, it is a big deal, and not all of them have been injured. When we got Winston, they had told us that when they called me, they said, Ian, would you be willing to accept a damaged tortoise? And I didn't know what that meant, but what they apparently the shapes on his shell aren't quite symmetrical because he might have been hit.
You're not damaged. Yeah. No, you're not. You're so sweet. Look how cute he is.
And look at he has the little chips on his shell, so
you know where he is.
Always know where he is.
And,
I'll tell you, we had quite a turnout. We had the governor who called in on the show today.
Wow.
We had Senator Tom Udall from New Mexico who wished him a happy hibernation, Mayor Curtis from Provo. We had quite, and Congressman Chris Stewart called up and said, okay, man up. You've got to vote first before you hibernate.
Wow.
So at least stay awake until November 8th.
How about that? That's amazing, you guys. And he'll live to be close to 100 or 100 years old, something like that?
So in captivity, they can live to be 100. So you've got to have a plan for when
you
pass away.
Yeah, you've got to pass him along in the will.
He's going to go into the third generation of the Wright family.
Well, that's great. Thanks for coming by and sharing the story. And hey, best of luck with your hibernation there, Winston. We'll see you in the spring, buddy. All right? Okay.
I'll babysit if you ever need one.
Okay.
Cool.
Perfect.
All right. Still to come on this Wednesday afternoon.